They have such passion for patient care and pathology in general. It's not only that they try to make the right diagnosis and really try to kind of hammer in the concepts of morphology and, you know, how to assess a case. It's that they really care about the practical implications for the patient. In every case that we get, the faculty are just so passionate about. I think that really lends itself to teaching at a high level.
The way this department does its work is really centered on residents. And the residents take responsibilities, for example, presenting in tumor board to our clinical colleagues, that in many programs are really reserved for fellows, creates a nice interaction and bond between the faculty and the residents, but also really prepares the residents for being, well, frankly, attendings, but certainly for being good fellows.
So we as a department are fully focused on resident education, not just training them as excellent pathologists, but also we want to train them as leaders in healthcare. In surgical pathology, we have more than 25 subspecialty faculty, and I can tell you every single one of them enjoys working with the residents and is very interested in resident education.
I guess we probably have like more than 50,000 cases a year, and that can just range from somewhat simple biopsies to really challenging, like cancer resections. I mean, I saw things that I've never dreamed of seeing and I've only read about in textbooks.
We provide forensic autopsy services to about 18 surrounding county medical examiners and coroners in Wisconsin. That is, they will bring the bodies of their cases to our facility for autopsy. That allows our residents to see forensic cases throughout their entire autopsy rotation because they're constantly going on. And this is in contrast to the majority of programs where the setup is residents are sent to the local medical examiner's office, which is often across town, and then they only get forensic exposure in a bolus fashion, like in a one-month rotation, for example.
I think many programs train residents well in AP, particularly in surgical pathology, but one of the great things about our program is that I think we do an amazing job of teaching CP as well.
Our CP core rotation provides a unique integrated approach to CP education, combining most of the subspecialties of the CP laboratory. This rotation is also 8 weeks long, which allows for involvement in long-term longitudinal projects, and it's repeated 3 times during the course of residency, allowing us to continually build upon the fundamentals and principles that we've previously covered on earlier rotations. We have recently introduced a CP leadership rotation for our third and fourth year residents, allowing them an opportunity to actively participate in leadership level decisions and discussions between faculty directors, medical directors, and laboratory administrators in the laboratory.
Our residents wind up going into a diversity of fellowship specialties. We've had residents go into informatics, into molecular pathology, into dermatopathology, neuropathology, and of course, surge path, forensic pathology, cytopathology, many other specialties. But the great thing about our program is no matter what that resident decides they want to go into, we can support them and train them well and help them attain that competitive fellowship they'd like in the specialty they ultimately select.
How I think, you know, when residents are here, I tell them there's kind of two main goals, overarching goals that you have. One is to become a competent pathologist in whatever specialty and then subspecialty you're interested in. And second is to attain a competitive fellowship of your choice, to go where you want to go and train in what you want to train in and have in a good, you know, in a competitive high caliber institution. And we do everything we can to attain both of those, our overarching goals for our residents. And we consistently do so.
Our program is focused on making sure that our residents are not fully drained doing the work, and they have time for personal activities and are able to enjoy life outside work and enjoy our beautiful city of Madison. We always like to encourage people to think more than just work. And I personally believe that when you have a strong hobby or something that you would like to pursue outside work, it makes you more effective in your work.
The interaction and the camaraderie among our residents is as good as it could be. And I think that lends itself well to a work-life balance for them.
We also have departmental R&D funds, and those R&D funds can be applied for by residents to help fund their research projects. Because as a resident, residents are busy. They don't have time to do 100 PCRs by hand or to do the bench work. But with that grant money, they can take that money funded through our department and use it to pay our translational research initiatives and pathology lab to do some of that bench work for them.
There's not an attitude of the residents are here to do my work or to do my cruddy work or to help me not be have to come to the hospital ever in the middle of the night, but rather the residents are here to learn. I want them to take responsibility. I want them to have to make a call because that's how you learn and that's how you get good. But they're here to learn, not to be left floundering.
It really is a privilege to be a residency program director and to get to work with the great crop of residents that we have in this program. I will say, for those who may be interviewing from California, I just want to warn you, we do get snow in the winter, but as long as you're capable of shoveling snow, you should be just fine.
I just got this certain kind of intangible vibe when I came here that I couldn't quite put my finger on, but there's something about it that seems special. And as I've been here over the last few years, I've recognized that, you know, just with our culture of our program, the personalities, the dedication to education, it's just really been a resident-geared program.